Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm recording about the LangChain use cases. We will speak about the extraction of the information from structured and unstructured sources. So I prepare a notebook as usual that later on I will push to the repository. And on the notebook, as usual, I'm working in Colab Pro. Today we don't need a GPU, so we can run this in my local machine. But I just prefer to do it this way because it's easy later to push to the repository. That's all. And then I give you some the relevant links just to get the relevant insights from LangChain documentation. And also some links as well to one of the tools that are also references in LangChain documentation. It's a Docker container which is already ready to go to do information extraction using LangChain, OpenAI, and Pydantic and Fast API with everything bucket and with a Postgres database. And it's Dockerized, it's really interesting tool, so I recommend you really to take a look to this repository and for this purpose, no? So as you can imagine, what the purpose of the extraction is, you just have a number of documents or a document if you want to extract information according to a template, if you want to say that, no? From that document, or and that document can be text document, CSV, PDF, or HTML, even XML, whatever is able to be opened with the LangChain. You create a template for that purpose. We will use Pydantic, the library Pydantic. We will speak about that right now, and you use the LLM just to to extract the information according to the template that you are creating with Pydantic. It's very powerful and had multiple use cases as well, and I will give you some examples and then you can experiment with them as well later on at your convenience. Again, for the purpose of this notebook and this tutorial, we will use Pydantic. Pydantic is a well-known library that is used to validate data in Python. It probably is the most extended tool. It's an evolution of what we know in the as data classes. And then, as you also may know, Python is not formally a strongly typed language, so we need to enforce the data type somehow with additional tools. In this case, Pydantic is one of the best, and then is as well widely used, and you probably even are using it. You are, for example, familiar with Fast API. It's also working in the under the hood with Pydantic. It's helped to define a strong data types and embedded in classes. Everything very Pythonic, and again, it's one of the tools most widely used today in order to do data validation with Python. And also, as I said, if you are working with the Fast API, also using Pydantic, and these Fast APIs is a tool also to create RESTful interfaces. So again, these two tools, especially Pydantic, is widely used for that purpose. And then, okay, let's go. We install the libraries we need. We move to the, we connect the driver, the locale, of the Colab Pro. We import the key of OpenAI. And in this case, we import the libraries we need, and we initialize a chat OpenAI class, and with the model GPT 3.5 Turbo, temperature 0, and simple initialization of the class. As I mentioned at the beginning of the series of videos, we will use OpenAI models. Just to make it easy, you can use the LLM at your convenience. As I said in the previous videos, just in case that you need to to split the long documents, you will need to adapt the length of the chunk to the input of the maximum input of the LLM that you are using for that purpose, to create embeddings or to create Lanchain documents. So the easiest way to do the document extraction is just provide a prompt, and inside the prompt provide a text, and you give some instructions to the LLM to extract information and also to format this information that you want to extract from the text in some format. No, in here what I'm providing a text, and here what I'm saying in the instruction is extract the name of the person and also extract the sentiment of the sentence associated with that person and create an emoji with that represent the sentiment of the sentence that is describing or the sentence that say that person. And then I create a simple example. John said that today he feels a bit under the water. Maria is surprised and just try to cheer him up, and Matthias is not attending and he's very busy. So the easiest example is this, and you will see what is the power of the LLM. It's just create, we just send this prompt to the LLM. We create the prompt here, we invoke the LLM with a human message. This is when you are working with the chat models, you need to create a message depending which role you want to use. In this case, we use the human message as we are the user. If you plan to use, there is another one that is the system, and there is three roles, but in this case, as we are the user, we are asking the LLM, you need to use the human message class, and in the content we send the prompt that we prepare about, and then we send this instruction with this text, and then on the answer, as you see, the LLM clearly recognize the names and also assign an emoji to each of the sentences that are associated to the name. John said that today feels a bit under the water. Well, this feeling sad, something like that. Here, surprise, Maria is surprised. And here, Matthias. Well, I'm not very familiar with this emoji, but I think he's quite, he's very busy, probably. But we can improve this as well, just saying that asking the LLM to explain the emoji as well, or to explain in a simple sentence what means the emoji. We can maybe probably assign an emoji. Let's try, this is a note, but again, I allow you. Okay, so here we are. So again, this is the simple way to use it. We will see now a little bit more complex and more probably useful way to use this. So again, we use PyDante. There is a specific class in LangChain to work with PyDante models. So a PyDante model is just a class to define the name. Here I just took an example I found, very interesting document I was reading before, and then just says you create a class with your heritage from base model. Base model is the main class in PyDantin. Each class is containing some attributes, and these attributes, as you see here, had some data types, and in the with the field you can get a description. These attributes and this description is the stuff is going to be used by the LLM to localize the information in the document. So you create, for example, in this class we want to retrieve from the document all these attributes, and then we give some tips or some trick, some information or context, no, to the LLM to find the relevant information inside the document. And then with that we create, first of all we create the class in PyDantin, and then we create the PyDantin parser this is a Lanchain class, and pass to this Lanchain class PyDantin parser the PyDantin class that created before. With this we create a parser, and then we create a chat prompt template with the message. This is the human message from template, and then here answer the user question as well as possible, and then we pass the instruction. This instruction is gonna be this class that we have here. It will be transforming in splitting in individual instructions that will be passed to the model, and the model it will extract all this the model finding, obviously it will try to find it in any case. In any way, it will try to find all it will transform all these individual attributes in instructions and extract the information according to what you write down in the description. And then here in the question you pass the test that you want to analyze, no? And then I make this example with one document. You can prepare whatever. It's just I prepare a document. I downloaded as well from the sample in internet. You just simply just see here is a, well, you just write a sentence. It's a PDF. We open it with the PY PDF loader. It's a loader from Lanchain, and then we create a Lanchain document. As you remember, the Lanchain documents contain two attributes: the metadata. The metadata in this case contains the source. This is we will probably need to open it because I already loaded document metadata, okay, and document content. So the metadata, depending on the loader that you are using, it will contain some attributes or others. As I mentioned in previous videos, you can include here whatever you want to help you later on to fine-tune or to narrow the query, that if you are using a vector embedding database or a retriever. So the metadata, if you don't include anything special, it's going to, well, by default it will, like in this case, for example, the name, the source of the information. In case it's a PDF with multiple pages, it will include the page, for example, that where the test is coming from. If you use PY PDF loader and here PDF loader just pointing to the path, which in loader you will have the, when you execute this in this way loader that load, it will generate a list of document. Every document is is one page of the PDF file. As in this case we only had one document in the list. So once you have the document the PDF in Lanchain document format, you create the query, and then create a profile based on this description, and you pass the content of the document. In this case, you use the form and using the method format prompt and passing the question and the information that you put in that variable you create the input, and with the input you invoke the chat model. And then we are going to receive an output, and after that the output received from the LLM, we will parse it out using the parser that we define here. And the parser is not other thing that a parser which will match the response of the LLM according to what you define here in the pedantic class. Let's take a look what's happening here. Okay, and then as you see here, we receive a class, an object, Twitter user, and then using the method dictionary, you can print as a dictionary the information. You can see here the power of this feature in LangChain and how is able the model to identify the information that is inside the document. Using the LLM and giving this at the end of the day, what we are doing with the pedantic class is just guiding the LLM to find the relevant information on the model. And the model is obviously very able to find the information when you give such kind of context. And then if you can generalize this, just imagine that you have thousands of documents, and in the documents you want to extract a set of the attributes for those documents, and then it's very easy to do create for example a structured database a tabular database just using this tool and extracting. You have thousands of PDFs and you can generate from those PDFs all this information just using something similar to this. Probably in some of the cases it can make some mistakes, but if you are able to introduce correct context for what you want to achieve, I think that the model will be able to find the information. It obviously exceeds on the document or in the text that you are passing to parse and to extract the information. Okay, here in the second example, I took some information I found here in this tool. That is the tool I was mentioning you before. It's a tool as well that is mentioned in and recommended on the LangChain documentation. It's just a Docker container which contain already all the logic to do information extraction from documents. You can send to the, and this is everything Dockerized and exposed via API using FastAPI. On the backend is working with PostgreSQL. And as you can read in the documentation, they are working with HTML, PDF, so it's worth it to take a look if you have a business case or use case that you pretend to extract information from documents or from. This is a tool that at least you have to take a look. It's ready to go. If you like the Dockers, you just need to replicate, to clone the repository and create a Docker. Very easy. Let's take a look what we have here. Yeah. Docker Compose, we have a Postgres database, backend, and frontend. So again, I will take a look in detail to the tool and I think later on, just for this tool, I will prepare a short video to look at the functionality of this tool, but I recommend you to use it. And then I took some examples from here, and then I'm not using in the notebook the tool. I'm just using the same approach that I took here, and then I took this other document that this is a financial report from Uber. I will post all this stuff to you be able later to replicate the tutorial in your local environment. And then I use this file. We load it as well with the PDF loader. We create another class. And then on here we just want to extract the key financial features from the document, And then on in this case, probably it's better, because here when you invoke the LLM, it's just extracting one key value. We can hear the one of the approaches to extract all the financial key data values from the document is probably to create a memory buffer and iterate and access the chatbot several times with containing the history of the previous questions and answers that the model provides in order not to repeat. We can personalize as well a little bit better this message and ask the and ask the model to send or to extract more information, for example, five or more key financial data from the report. So this example probably had plenty of room to improve, but well, it's just an example, an additional example that I wanted to show you. So I think it's very powerful, this functionality or this feature of the LangChain, and it had multiple use cases where you can apply it, and then on, probably in business is one of the most probably direct use cases, because you know, every day, you probably know as me, we manage a lot of the unstructured documentation, like PDFs on data lakes or JSON files or XML. A lot of the stuff that is very very hard to work with, and then on using this this tool, if we had the budget to work with the models, for example, like OpenAI, we can build a very powerful extraction tool and automatized pipelines with quickly and easily extract all the relevant information that we had in thousands of documents and do it very quickly. And with that, we can later even create a structured database and create some other applications on top of that. So that's all. I hope that you like. I will post later to the repository, and I will put on the description all this all the information relevant for this video. And again, I hope that you like. And as I used to say, if you like it, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Okay, thank you very much. See you soon. Bye.